Come on, let's all welcome Boys Avenue!
Hi guys, welcome to
Please
Showtime Online.
Please greet our Madlang Onliners.
What's up, Madlang Onliners? Yay. Boys Avenue here, we're happy to be here.
Yeah, so how does it feel that you are here once again on Showtime stage? How does it feel?
It feels amazing. It's become a tradition at this point. I think the very first time we played on this stage was around February
2009?
2009?
Wow.
10 years ago.
I think it was ASAP 09 at the time.
Right, right.
What is the disadvantage? Of being, you know,
being with
brothers.
Your brothers.
Yes. there is
a
disadvantage.
The disadvantage. I think it's exactly what I just said. It's that we're around each other all the time.
Well, you know, and I was actually thinking about it earlier today that as we get older and we have children and families, it is kind of weird that when we're gone, there's nobody back home, you know? Like, at least if we weren't in a band together and he left, I could, like, hang out with his children and still be helping out back home.
Yeah.
But when we leave, we're all gone, you know what I mean? But that's kind of like a boring answer, but it is interesting that it is weird to leave all of our
answer,
kids
right?
behind. Yeah.
Have you guys ever like fought before a show?
Yeah, I was.
Or during a show?
We
or
never
anything
before a show.
Something
it's
like
always
worse.
On the bus afterwards.
After.
Usually.
After.
It is usually on the bus.
Yes.
We used to fight a little bit more when we were younger, and you know, like when you're first starting a band, and there's that uncertainty, and you don't know if you're going to have success, and every decision seems like it's the most important decision.
Yes.
We used to fight a little bit more back then, but like now that we're older and everything's great and we're blessed that everything's going well, there's nothing worth fighting about, you know what I mean?
But where did the idea come from to start a band with your brothers?
I think it was pretty natural. I don't remember there being like a definitive moment. I think we always just used to do stuff together.
So whether it was basketball or soccer, like various sports, it's like when one person got really into something, the other two usually kind of got into it. So I think it was the same thing where we were all very musical, like even on road trips as kids, we have so many memories of us singing together for fun. And then when I picked up guitar, Fabian picked up guitar, then he had started playing bass, he played violin in high school. So it was like, it kind of just took on this natural progression, pun intended.
So at what age you actually started like discovering that you have passion for music?
I think it was around our teens. I would say it was in like the early teenage years, because I think when we were kids we would sing all the time, but then when we were like in like preteen vibe, it was very much about sports and athletics.
Right.
And then I think in our teenage years, the music came back in where we started listening to lyrics and songs and connecting with it. You start to get older. So that was kind of around the era for us.
So we started playing instruments when we were teenagers, you know, but even when he was younger, like I remember we used to have like a boombox that had cassettes in it, you know, so like when you were listening to the radio, you'd put a cassette and you'd hit record and you could actually take music from the radio and put it on your tape or whatever. But we have a tape where
the young listeners are like, what is this technology?
We have a cassette tape where he was singing to Boyz II Men, and he must have been, I think, only like 8 years old, right?
I was like five or six.
Oh, wow. So, see, even as young kids, he had a great voice. You know what I mean? But we didn't start playing guitar till we were probably like 12 or 13.
Interesting.
Yeah, but the name, I heard that the name came from like the streets you grew up as kids, right? Boys Avenue.
That's exactly right, yeah. There's two streets that the vast majority of our memories came from in Sarasota, and we just combined the two of them.
So whose idea? Is this your idea?
I don't remember how.
You know what's funny is for a couple shows we were called Interval, which is like the interval is like the space between two musical notes.
Yeah.
And then we ended up just collectively after a show chatting and changing it to Boyz Avenue. But now his kids have a
YouTube channel. No, I'll be honest. The main reason this kind of dates us, but the main reason we changed our name was because myspace.com/interval was taken.
Oh wow.
So we were like, clearly MySpace is the future. We need a more unique name. So we changed our name, and I'm happy we did, but it's been amazing to see it get new life with his sons.
If you go to YouTube,
interval941.com/interval941,
his kids have a YouTube channel, and it actually has a lot of subscribers.
Yeah. Nice.
They're not on MySpace.
No, they don't know anything about MySpace.
Yes.
We have a few questions for you guys, since you guys are brothers. You've known each other all your lives, like since birth.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Our writer is curious to find out who sleeps the longest.
Wow.
Who sleeps the longest? All of them, because they're them.
We're all really good at sleeping.
Who eats the most?
Ooh. I love food. Yeah, I love food. I have a trouble with portion control.
Eating and drinking.
Eating and drinking. All right, and last
one.
Who gets the most screams from girls?
Alejandro,
for sure.
Yeah, the lead singer. Like he's got the voice of an angel, so.
I'll let them answer that.
All right, okay. Can we ask for a sample, just a short sample of any song? Or before that, I'd like to ask, of all the covers you've done, which song is your favorite or you perform frequently?
You want to go one by one? I would say for me, Fast Car is my to perform, especially to perform live. That's like my favorite. What about
Tracy
you
Chapman? Yeah.
Here we go.